As I said previously, QEMU provides quite a rich ecosystem. It has many features. Definitely, you can easily find documentation which describes all these interesting features. One of the most important one that it's good to use during the firmware development is GDB hooking with GDB to QEMU and debug whatever is running inside. Some execution logs, some dumping of the what's going on inside the emulated environment. We can precisely see, for example, from what locations code that is running inside QEMU reads, where it writes. I know there is some work related to management engine emulation, and then you can of course like do some exploration of the systems if you are interested in that part. There are many other ways. There are some extensions to QEMU, for example, to support the RTM, to support SGX. QEMU is very, very rich and can be very helpful during the firmware development. Of course, like how typically you will use that. It has good potential to do shift left strategy, so you don't have hardware or you are limited with some porting capabilities, or you simply just developing some payload and you don't have to do that on the hardware. And that's good because like you can speed up develop, test, fix cycle just basing on QEMU. Of course, this means some level of abstraction, and then you have to understand what's the difference between what you have in QEMU and what you have in real hardware. Other things which are very important are implementations of support for RISC-V and OpenPower in QEMU. Thanks to that, porting coreboot was quite easy. At least there were tools for that. And that definitely speed up growth of ecosystem of alternative architectures which bring additional value in area of openness, in area of security, which should be of interest to any coreboot fan, coreboot enthusiast. So let's go to the quizzes and assignment.